Now, Heartland Sports with Todd Richards.
Hi again, everyone. It's the first week of the regular season for teams in Southeast Missouri and Southern Illinois. Let's take a look at the highlights from the jungle, and you can see Cape Central coming on the field. They had a lot of emotion coming out, and they also had a lot of emotion from the line of scrimmage. Watch Keyshawn Boyd. You've heard that name before, man. They have thunder and lightning and all kinds of stuff in that backfield. Made it 7-0 over New Madrid County Central, and they weren't finished. I'll tell you what, their defense was also playing well. Nolan Mungle, the quarterback for New Madrid, that short reception, but look at the Tigers swarm them right there. And then a huge play coming up from not a big guy, but an amazing player, Zaire Thomas. He actually cut the ribbon on their new indoor facility earlier in the day. This time he goes the distance for the touchdown. That made it 14-0. We'll put the final up on the board for you. Cape Central 42-0 over New Madrid. Well, our Heartland Football Friday game of the night features Murfreesboro at Carbondale. During halftime, they recognize the Terriers 24 Athletics Hall of Fame class. And then here you go, Murfreesboro's first play on offense, Tyjer Kellum. He goes the distance, 8-0. Red Devils on defense. They come up with the pick right there. Meanwhile, Red Devils would end up getting a field goal. Carbondale, how about Davon Woolley? He goes in for the touchdown. And we're going to go ahead and put the score that we've got in the third quarter. It was 25-15, the score. All right, check our featured games ahead tonight on Heartland Football Friday. In addition to New Madrid County Central at Cape, Scott City coach Brian Booby makes his debut at East Prairie. Former Rams coach Jim May his debut at Sykeston. Crystal City, another good matchup at Kelly. Also, you can check out some of these games. Jackson at Cardinal Ritter, Valley View at Poplar Bluff, Murfreesboro at Carbondale, and then, of course, the Harrisburg at Anna Jonesboro. Another new coach, somewhat of a theme that we've got going on, new coaches. It's all coming up tonight at 10 on Heartland Football Friday. A lot of plays, a lot of stories. Well, the SEMO football team will go for its second win in program history tomorrow when the Red Devils travel to New Mexico State. SEMO is coming off an opening game win over North Alabama in the FCS kickoff, but things figure to get a lot tougher against the Aggies from the FBS, who are listed as 8.5-point favorites. Coach Tuke is well aware of the challenge ahead, but he also likes his team's chances.
The advantage we have is we played a game, and you make the most improvement all year long from game one to game two. And so if we have a humble team, which we'll find out, if we have a humble team, we'll have a team that really gets better from game one to game two. And if we don't, all right, that'll be a shame.
SEMO and New Mexico State are scheduled to kick off at 8 p.m. tomorrow in Las Cruces. Saluki is also preparing for a big matchup at BYU, another FBS school. That one's set for 7 tomorrow. SEMO opening up the college volleyball season at Arkansas State. And some really good serves coming out here for the Redhawks. Nice one there, but at the end it was Arkansas State winning the match. 3-0 the final in this one. And we finish up with a golf event. The Jackson Lady Indians win the Webster Scramble. They beat out 18 other teams. Congrats, ladies.